a very important play here for both teams. Now, what the kicking team is going to do is they want speed on there. They're going to kick something where you hope the ball can flop over and then get up in the air. And the Eagles are going to have their onside kicking team. The Redskins are going to have their hands guys. You see all these guys here, defensive backs, wide receivers, linebackers. They're all going to be, you're going to have 10 guys up and just one deep. And you're taking every gap so that when the guy kicks the ball, that you can catch it. And you have your best guys, your best hands guys up there. Fiegels has to make something happen with the ball. You got to put something on the ball. And it starts with the way you tee it up. You see the way they did? They didn't even put it on the tee. They put it in front of the tee. So that's going to make a flip end over end.
Like a mole's been at work at RFK. I don't know which way it's going now. It's going to be Fiegels and the Redskins had it and lost it. And a scramble. The officials down close to the bottom of the pile. The Redskins do get it. And when you see the head coach take off the headset, you know that today belongs to the other people.
And you know that the hands team work. Do the ball now. The Redskins can come up before 10 yards. The Eagles, the kicking team, can't catch it before it goes 10 yards. Now the hands team at first, it didn't work. Then the hands team right there, Wilbur Marshall again making a heck of a play.
Wilbur Marshall.
He's had a good week because this is the second game he played this week. You remember Monday night, yep, and then Sunday, and he has had a heck of a week.
The Eagles have no timeouts, so all the Redskins have to do is say we'll see you later. Marshall recovered that fumble. Richie Pettibone overlooking at him. Joe Gibbs shaking hands with Rich Kotite. Click. So for John Madden, this is Pat Summerall saying so long from RFK Stadium, where the final score was the Redskins 16, the Eagles 12.
Well, certainly not the game that we all expected, and I'm not sure that either of those teams really looked like Super Bowl contenders. But you must say that the Washington Redskins offense played a superb game. But what didn't they do? They didn't put the ball in the end zone. At the end of the day, I think that's got to come back to Mark Rypien. He has got to lead this team, has got to lead them offensively. If he can do that, they can certainly move on and maybe again retain their title as champions. But their defense also played a great game, and that meant that the Herschel Walker and Randall Cunningham duo that we said might make the difference couldn't quite do it. Anyway, so the Redskins move on. That's a big win for them. Let's go now and have a look at what's happening in the other two games that we've been watching today. Into the final period at Soldier Field, Mike Ditka's Bears leading 21-7, but the Buccaneers are in possession and on Chicago's one-yard line. Despite Mike Singletary's menacing looks, Tampa's Reggie Rotkov managed to break away and score the one-yard touchdown. On the Buccaneers' next possession, Vinny Testaverde went to the air, but was picked off, this time by Sean Gale. Uh-oh, not again, Vinny. The Bears decided to go to the running game and gave the ball to Neil Anderson, who made the first down with this 10-yard gain. Chicago, however, had to settle for this Kevin Butler 25-yard field goal. With time running out, the Buccaneers decided to play on this fourth down. However, Vinny was called for intentional grounding, and possession went back to the Bears. Chicago took advantage, and Darren Lewis ran into the end zone for a touchdown. And the Bears are looking good. The final score there, Chicago winning it 31-14. Over at Texas Stadium, the Chiefs started the final period, trailing 17-10. On Kansas City's first possession, Dave Craig couldn't make any ground and was sacked by the Cowboys' defensive tackle, Jimmy Jones. Not to be outdone, the Chiefs' defense replied by intercepting a Troy Aikman pass. This was Dale Carter getting pulled down there eventually. The final period was dominated by the defensive teams. In one final attempt to drive forward, Craig was once more intercepted, this time by Ray Horton. So the final score, the Cowboys winning it 17-10. Oh, my goodness, it sort of turns things around in the NFC East, and maybe it's the Cowboys that are a team to beat now, Gary.
I think it's wide open for the Phoenix Cardinals, but you're right, it is wide open. It's like a game of paper, scissors, stone, the NFC East. The Redskins always seem to beat the Eagles beat the Cowboys, and the Cowboys beat the Redskins. So, wide open.
It's going to be interesting to see what happens there, and again, I still think it might be the Super Bowl winners that are from that league. Now let's go and have a look at the other two games that were played today. And the Packers losing that game 17-10, and I know Mike Tomczak's happy about that because that's his former team, the Packers. And then the Indianapolis Colts going down to San Diego. So Bobby Ross excited about that win for his San Diego Chargers. Well, there are no clues to the likely Super Bowl contenders among those two scores, but Matthew Allen of Berkshire and Stephen Reed of Hertfordshire came one step closer to Pasadena when they entered our Super Bowl competition. Along with the correct forecast, they told us that the Los Angeles Raiders were the last AFC team to win the Super Bowl. Good memories, lads. There's an NFL starter jacket on its way to both of them, and they go forward to our playoff question at the end of the season. If you entered but didn't win, why not try again today? All you have to do is pick up the phone and dial 0891 300 700 and tell us who will win between first the Chicago Bears and Green Bay Packers. This is always a ferocious local clash. Two Bears wins last year certainly will motivate the Pack. Second, it's the Washington Redskins at Minnesota. The reigning Super Bowl champions face another real test, this time from Tennis Green and his rampaging Vikings. Third, it's Detroit and they're at Tampa Bay. Surprise form from both these teams. The Bucks are up, but the Lions are down. And then tell us who was the last team to win successive Super Bowls. The number to dial is 0891 300 700. And as usual, the lines are open until 5 p.m. next Sunday. Calls are charged at 36 pence per minute cheap rate and at 48 pence per minute all other times. The average length of your call is under 3 minutes. Washington at Minnesota. That's a tough one to call, and the Metrodome is definitely a tough place to play. I know I've been there. Dennis Green has done a great job with the Vikings, but Joe Gibbs and the Redskins, as we saw today, are always prepared. It's going to be a great game. If you want to catch up with the news and action from your favourite team, then join us again for Play Action next Saturday at 11:30. Next week marks the halfway point of the regular season, and we'll be back live from our studios here in Atlanta with the very best from the NFL. That's Sunday at 8:30. So until then, good night. Thank you.